this video, I show you how Kruskal's algorithm finds a minimum spanning tree in a weighted undirected graph. A spanning tree is a connected and acyclic subgraph that contains all vertices. So for example, the vertices and edges in orange form a spanning tree. The weight of the spanning tree is the sum of all edge weights. In this case, the weight is 47. The goal of Kruskal's algorithm is now to find a spanning tree that has the smallest possible weight. Let's go through Kruskal's algorithm step by step. The algorithm simply adds an edge with lowest weight in every iteration such that no cycle is created. The smallest weight is -4, so we add edge DE. Now, the second smallest weight is -1 and we add edge FG. So we now just continue in the same way. We add edge AC with weight 2 and edge BC with weight 3. The next edge that we would like to add is edge AB with a weight of 6. But if we add this edge, we would create a green cycle on vertices A, B and C. So that's why we do not insert this edge. Instead, we color it red and ignore this edge from now on. Instead, we add edge CE, which has a weight of 7. Now, among all remaining edges, there are 3 edges which have the same lowest edge weight of 8. We are not allowed to pick this edge BE, because if we do so, then we would create a green cycle again. The other edges with weight 8, namely DF and EF, are fine. For those edges, we have 3 choices. I pick edge EF. Now we can't add any more edges without creating a cycle. That means that Kruskal's algorithm is now finished and has found this minimum spanning tree with a weight of 15. So finally, here's some information about Kruskal's algorithm. Kruskal's algorithm is also a so-called greedy algorithm. The graph must be a connected, weighted, and undirected graph. Kruskal's algorithm works also if the graph contains some edges with a negative weight. In general, the minimum spanning tree is not unique, so there can be different minimum spanning trees for a graph. But if you have a graph where all edge weights are different, then you can be sure that there's exactly one minimum spanning tree. The time complexity depends mainly on 2 components. There's the component for sorting the edges, and there's also the component for checking if adding an edge would create a cycle. Sorting edges is the dominant component, so that the total time complexity is the number of edges times the logarithm of the number of edges. This also means that Kruskal's algorithm is rather slow if the graph has many edges. But on the positive side, Kruskal's algorithm is very easy to implement. That is all the key information about Kruskal's algorithm. I hope you could take away some bits and pieces from this video. If you did, please subscribe to this channel. And if you want to find out more about algorithms on minimum spanning trees, Prim's algorithm here is the right thing for you. Thanks and bye bye.